President Biden told reporters he is on the verge of announcing a massive infrastructure plan that, according to some estimates, could cost in the range of $3 trillion. Jobs, the president says, will be the key.
If you think about it, it's the place where we will be able to significantly increase American productivity, at the same time providing really good jobs for people. But we can't build back to what they used to be. We have to build the environments. Global warming's already done significant damage.
Those concerns about the environment were the main reason behind one of his first decisions as president to cancel the permits for the planned Keystone pipeline, which was to carry oil from the tar sands of Canada to the United States. But the Canadian company behind the pipeline said thousands of jobs would be lost. Here in the United States, the ripple effects were also felt almost instantly, especially in South Dakota. And that's where Martin Savidge went to examine the aftermath.
I'm going to sign you, and that's what I'm going to do while you're all here.
When President Biden revoked the construction permit of the Keystone XL pipeline, environmentalists celebrated. 1,500 miles from Washington, in Myrtle, South Dakota, population 444, Jeff Berkland had a different reaction.
How did you feel?
Like I got kicked in the stomach, honestly. I didn't feel good at all.
He's the CEO of a tiny electric cooperative with a big opportunity, building two substations providing power to two of the pipeline's pumping stations.
And each one of those would generate how much financially for you?
Roughly $500,000 a month.
This for a company that has only seen 99 new customers in 30 years. The profits would have all gone back to the co-op's 3,700 members.
Roughly, our members on average would have received about a $325 credit annually. That would be theirs.
Additionally, he says tens of thousands of tax dollars would have trickled down to the local school district and its 190 students. But all that vanished with the stroke of a presidential pen. In Phillips, South Dakota, population 779, Tricia Burns and her husband had just invested their own money expanding Ignite, a fitness center, hoping to make a little extra from the pipeline workers coming to town.
So, you know, the old saying, you got to make hay when the sun shines. And we felt like the sun was going to be shining and we needed to take advantage of that.
She watched Biden's inauguration on television.
And then the executive order started coming in. And when he signed the bill to pull the permit, it was a tough, tough moment here at Ignite.
By midnight, she says, 45 members had called to cancel memberships.
In a big city, that doesn't matter. Here, that's over half of our memberships. Here, that's $3,000 in recurring monthly income. That matters.
The town of Phillip also saw benefits. TC Energy, the pipeline's owner, contributed money towards a new fire truck, new sidewalks, even local sports. Construction crews spent money at local stores. Biden's opposition to the project wasn't a surprise. How fast everything stopped was.
Everything had been signed, sealed, delivered, and that was all taken away in an instant.
TC Energy estimates nearly 1,000 employees have been laid off.
There's all this money invested into this and all these jobs that people are basically promised, and then the president can just sign an executive order and shut it all down, you know?
No one we talked to seems to know what comes next. TC Energy hasn't replied to our request for comment, but has said it was disappointed by President Biden's decision. Environmentalists had argued the pipeline and the oil would have added to climate change and feared damage to water and wildlife where the pipeline went through. But stopping the pipeline has problems of its own, like what happens to the land that was already bought.
Another concern, what do you do with all the stuff? Pipeline assets are spread across hundreds of miles, much of it now just stranded.
Pumping stations, construction camps, and piles of pipe sit vacant and marooned. Many here saw the pipeline as a chance to do better. Now its remnants litter the landscape, haunting reminders of what might have been.
Joins us now from South Dakota. Is there any hope among the people you spoke to that this project could be revived? Or, I mean, what are they hoping is going to happen?
Yeah, it depends who you talk to, Anderson.
Some people actually are holding out hope about a federal lawsuit that's now been filed on behalf of 21 Republican-led states. It's alleging that President Biden didn't have the authority to cancel the permit as he did. Court cases take a long time. Other people are actually hoping that President Biden has a change of heart. They would love to be able to plead their case. And then there are those who are hoping for a change of politics, maybe midterm elections, a change of power leadership in both the House and Senate, more favorable to the pipeline. Some even hold out to 2024 and maybe a change of administration.